and Morning Spring Forward. I'm Shane Eisenhower with Kelly Early. Will the following students please report to room 125 to see Mr. Miscavige? Taryn Carmody, Aaron McHugh, Megan Albach, Julie Avens, and Stacy Swinehart. Any Key Club member participating in the Relay for Life race should meet in 254 now. Again, any Key Club member participating in the Relay for Life race should meet in Mrs. Mann's room right now.
Attention seniors and faculty, we're looking for suggestions for our 2003 senior class gift. Please drop off your suggestions in the box in the main office by Friday, May 30th. Applications are now available for next year's WSF TV crew. Believe me, the requirements aren't tough. I made it. So stop in the TV studio ASAP and pick one up. They are due back to Miss Mirza by Friday, May 30th.
Attention all music students. Please reserve this Friday, May 30th, for the end of the year Music Awards Banquet, which will be held from 6 to 10 p.m. There will be a brief yet mandatory meeting for the newly elected junior class officers on Tuesday, June 3rd, 2003, immediately after school in room 151. And now here's Rachel Harsh with sports. Rachel?
Okay, attention girls track team, please stop by the athletic director's office this week to get your tickets to the championship banquet. You must have a ticket to attend. And attention golfers, there's a mandatory sign-up meeting for golf today, May 28th, in the high school cafeteria at 2:45. Any 9th, 10th, and 11th grade girl interested in playing field hockey next fall, there will be a very important field hockey meeting this Thursday, May 29th at 2:45 in room 125. Attendance is strongly recommended. That's it in sports. Now let's take it back to Kelly.
Thanks, Rachel. And now here's a word from the office. Thank you, Mrs. Savage. And now here's Justin Blustery Digby with the weather.
Thank you, Kelly. As you can see, the front that we had yesterday moved offshore, but there's still that upper level low that's giving us problems. The high pressure system is in place and it is trying to give us nice weather, but it's not going to work because of another low coming in with rain moving across all week. So let's go to the forecast. Today, there's a possibility of rain all day. It looks like it could rain any time. And then, of course, for the weekend, it's going to rain again. Nothing new here, but now back to the desk.
Thank you, Justin. On the lunch menu for today, it's your choice of Pizza Bob or grilled cheese.
All right, well, this is Spring Forward in the Morning for Wednesday, May 28th, the 168th day of school and F Day. With Kelly Early, Rachel Harsh, and Justin Digby, I'm Shane Eisenhower. Have a great day. And stay.
head. One shot. One opportunity. To seize everything you ever wanted. One moment. Did you capture? Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, loud. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity, choke. He's so mad, but he won't give up. Won't have it, he knows his whole back to these ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's pro. He's so stagnant, he knows when he goes back to this mobile home. That's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody better go capture this moment and hope it don't do better. Lose his mouth in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose his mouth in the music, the moment you own it. The taking, make me king as we move toward a new world order. A normal life is boring, but superstardom's close to postmortem. It only grows harder, homie grows hotter. He blows, it's all over. These hoes is all on him. Coast to coast shows, he's known as the Globetrotter. Lonely roads, God only knows he's grown farther from home. He's no father. He goes home and barely knows his own daughter. But hold your nose, cause here goes the cold water. These hoes don't want him no more. He's cold product. They moved on to the next smoke who flows. He knows dove and sold nada. So the soap opera is told. It unfolds, I suppose it's old partner. But the beat goes on. Da-da-dum, you better lose his mouth in the music. The moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose his mouth in the music. The moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. No more games, I'ma change what you call rage. Tear this forth like two dogs cage. I was playing in the beginning, the mood all changed. I've been chewed up and spit out and booed off stage. But I kept rhyming and stepped right in the next cipher. Best believe somebody's paying the Pied Piper. All the pain inside amplified by the fact that I can't get by with my 9 to 5. And I can't provide the right type of life for my family. Cause man, these stamps don't buy diapers. And it's no movie, there's no Mekhi Pfeiffer. This is my life and these times are so hard. And it's getting even harder trying to feed and water my seed. Plus, see the thought I caught up between being a father and a prima donna. Baby mama drama screaming on her too much for me to want to stay in one spot. Another damn monotony's gotten me to the point.
Good morning, Springfoot. I'm Dara Reese here with the lovely Kelly Early. And attention all students in Mrs. Lanyon's period 5-6 health class. Meet today in the 213 computer lab. That's Mrs. Lanyon's 5-6 health class in the 213 computer lab. And attention seniors and faculty, we're looking for suggestions for our 2003 senior class gift. Please drop off your suggestions in the box in the main office by Friday, May 30th.
Applications are now available for next year's WSF TV crew. Stop in the TV studio ASAP and pick one up. They are due back to Miss Mirza by Friday, May 30th. Attention seniors going on the class trip. You must be here at 6:30 Tuesday morning. We will return at approximately 9 p.m. Please make sure you bring money for lunch and dinner in the park. Breakfast will be provided at Shady Maple. Please check the list outside Miss Cantella's room 162 to see which bus you will be riding on. If you have any questions, see Miss Cantella in room 162.
And there will be a brief yet mandatory meeting for the newly elected junior class officers on Tuesday, June 3rd, 2003, immediately after school in room 151. And now, here's that queen of sass, Miss Rachel Harsh, with our sports today. How's it going?
It's good. How are you?
Good.
All right. Attention, the girls track team. Please stop by the athletic director's office this week to get your tickets to the championship banquet. You must have a ticket to attend. And any 9th, 10th, or 11th grade girl interested in playing field hockey next fall, there will be a very important field hockey meeting today, May 29th, at 2:45 in room 125. Attendance is strongly recommended. That's all I have for sports today, so let's take it back to Kelly.
Well, thank you, Rachel. And now here's a word from the office. Mrs. Savage, and now here's Justin Blustery Digby with the WSF TV Finger on the Weather Pulse.
Well, thank you, Kelly. As you can see, we have this low pressure system here that's going to be bringing us the chance of showers and thunderstorms this afternoon for the next couple days. Two high pressure systems out here. I'm hoping that they're going to move over and give us some nice weather for once. Let's go to the 4-day. And as you can see, there are no rain on the forecast for the next 2 days. A chance of sparse thunderstorms on Saturday. And as you can see, the highs are going to try and get a little warmer, but that cold front's going to come through and cool it back down. Now back over to the desk.
Thank you, Justin. On the lunch menu for today, it's your choice of roast pork or breaded fried chicken.
So much for being a vegetarian.
Yeah.
And, you know, to my girl Britt, happy birthday, love, Gabby. That was you, dear, but you missed it. So this is Springfoot in the Morning for Thursday, May 29th, the 169th day of school in A Day. With Kelly Early, the sparkly Rachel Harsh, and the blustery Justin Digby, I'm Darius. Have a Two Kings kind of Thursday, but don't forget to stay tuned for yet another hip and rad Springford music video.
Say goodbye to you.
Forward. I'm Shane Eisenhower here with Kelly Early. Seniors, if you are going to apply to Montgomery County Community College, you can save the $20 application fee by applying online. Please don't forget to notify guidance so your transcript will be sent. Attention seniors and faculty, we are looking for suggestions for our 2003 senior class gift. Please drop off your suggestions in the box in the main office by today, May 30th.
Applications are now available for next year's WSF TV crew. Stop in the TV studio ASAP and pick one up. They are due back to Ms. Mirza by today, May 30th. The Art Enrichment Group formally presented to SFHS and the community their fifth project, Glass Autumn. An array of hand-cast glass leaves can be viewed in the high school media center. Parents, administrators, staff, and press gathered Tuesday evening at 7 p.m. for the presentation. Even Channel 6 stopped by for their 11 o'clock blurb. Cartha Kolar, artist in residence, and Mrs. Burkhart addressed the group of onlookers in the media center.
Juniors in National Honor Society who wish to help at graduation or baccalaureate should sign up in the media center. And attention all gifted seniors, the gifted senior farewell breakfast will be held on Wednesday, June 4th at 7 a.m. in room 129. Attention seniors going on a class trip, you must be here at 6:30 Tuesday morning. We will return at approximately 9 p.m. Please make sure you bring your money for lunch and dinner in the park. Breakfast will be provided at Shady Maple. Please check the list outside Ms. Cantella's room, 162, to see which bus you'll be riding on. If you have any questions, see Ms. Cantella in room 162.
To complete library inventory, the Media Center will be closed to classes and study halls beginning Monday, June 2nd. Library aides must still report. Students may return books before or after school each day. All books must be returned and all fines must be paid to receive a diploma or a report card. Reading Club will have their picnic in the courtyard after school on Tuesday, June 3rd. Suzanne's Diary for Nicholas and Breakfast of Champions will be discussed. Come even if you haven't read the books, as election of officers and next year's book choices will be determined.
Extended hours for the Media Center will be continued through Wednesday, June 4th. The Media Center will be open until 4 p.m. on Tuesday, June 3rd. And will be open Wednesday evening from 6 to 9 p.m. on June 4th to accommodate students studying for finals and finishing reports. After that, closing will be at 3:10 each day. And there will be a brief yet mandatory meeting for the newly elected junior class officers on Tuesday, June 3rd, 2003, immediately after school in room 151.
Attention Science Club members, there will be a meeting on Monday, June 2nd, immediately after school in room 103.
Please plan to attend.
And there will be a very important art enrichment meeting on Thursday, June 5th in room 164. Every member should attend. The meeting will run until 3:30 only. And now here's the queen of SES, Rachel Harsh with the sports. Rachel.
All right. This past Wednesday evening at Sunnybrook Ballroom in Pottstown, four of our athletes and one team received the prestigious Summit Award. The Summit Awards are presented to those individuals or team who left their indelible mark on athletics with performance, academics, courage and service. We proudly announce our recipients. Emily Christie, outstanding individual performance by a female. Amanda Guthridge, outstanding career performance for a female. Craig Clark, sportsmanship for a male. Our football team won the Most Memorable Moment Award when they were the first and only team to score on Pottstown during their regular season. Eric Gull, who kicked the field goal, is representing the team. And Sterling Johnson won the Most Courageous Male Award. The Summit Awards program will be televised on PCTV Channel 4, commencing this evening at 10 p.m.
On behalf of all the recipients, we would like to say thank you to the Jazz Band and the Magical Choir for outstanding performances and for making it a very special night. Thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations to our recipients. And attention, girls track team, please stop by the athletic director's office this week to get your tickets to the championship banquet. You must have a ticket to attend. In physical education, this year there was a badminton and table tennis tournament. The winners of these tournaments are Rachel Myers, Beth Wallace, Julie Avens, and Krista Hiley. The winner of the Spring Ford Idol Walk-A-Mile is Stephanie Dew. Great job to all the girls who participated in the Walk-A-Mile contest. All winners are to see Mrs. Mars and Mrs. Staley after announcements to collect their prize. That's it in sports. Now let's take it back to Kelly.
Thank you, Rachel. And now here's a word from the office. Thank you, Mrs. Savage, and a special weather notice from Justin Blustery Digby. Watch out for rain and possible thunderstorms tomorrow, but Sunday is all aces. On the lunch menu for today, it's your choice of pizza sticks or chicks fajitas. Happy belated birthday to Brittany from Bathaby, Candica, and Gabriella.
Okay, this is Spring for the Morning for Thursday, May 30th, the 178th day of school, a B-Day. With Kelly Early, Rachel Harsh, I'm Shane Eisenhower. Have a great day. Good morning, Spring Ford. I'm Shane Eisenhower here with Kelly Early. Seniors, if you are going to apply to Montgomery County Community College, you can save the $20 application fee by applying online. Please don't forget to notify guidance so your transcript will be sent. And attention seniors going on the class trip, you must be here by 6:30 Tuesday morning, and the buses will leave promptly at 6:45 a.m. We will not wait, so don't be late. We will return at approximately 9 p.m., and please make sure you bring your money for lunch and dinner in the park. Breakfast will be served for, will be provided at Shady Maple. Please check the list outside Ms. Cantello's room 162 to see which bus you will be riding on. If you have any questions, see Ms. Cantello in room 162.
Attention Science Club members, there will be a meeting today, June 2nd, immediately after school in room 103. Please plan to attend. Reading Club will have their picnic in the courtyard after school on Tuesday, June 3rd. Suzanne's Diary for Nicholas and Breakfast of Champions will be discussed. Come even if you haven't read the books, as election of officers and next year's book choices will be determined. Juniors and National Honor Society who wish to help at graduation or baccalaureate should sign up in the Media Center. Attention all gifted seniors. The Gifted Senior Farewell Breakfast will be held on Wednesday, June 4th at 7 a.m. in room 129. To complete library inventory, the Media Center will be closed to classes and study halls beginning Monday, June 2nd. Library aides must still report. Students may return books before or after school each day. All books must be returned and fines must be paid to receive a diploma and or report card.
Extended hours for the Media Center will be continued through Wednesday, June 4th. The Media Center will open until 4 p.m. on Tuesday, June 3rd. And will be open Wednesday evening from 6 to 9 p.m. on June 4th to accommodate students studying for finals and finishing reports. After that, closing will be at 3:10 each day. And there will be a brief yet mandatory meeting for the newly elected junior class officers on Tuesday, June 3rd, 2003, immediately after school in room 151. And there will be a very important art enrichment meeting on Thursday, June 5th, in room 164. Every member should attend. The meeting will run until 3:30 only. And now here's Rachel Harsh for sports. Rachel.
All right. Physicals for fall senior high school sports will be conducted tomorrow. Athletes are to meet in the auxiliary gym at the following times. Tuesday, June 3rd. 2:35, girls volleyball. 3 o'clock, girls soccer. 3:20, boys soccer. 3:40, cheerleaders. 4 o'clock, field hockey. 4:10, boys and girls cross country. 4:25, girls tennis. 4:40, football. And 5 o'clock, golf. All outstanding obligations must be taken care of before you are able to get a physical for fall sports. Stop by the athletic director's office if you are in need of a physical packet for tomorrow. This will be the only time the school physicals will be given for sports physicals. All other physicals will have to be scheduled by your parents at their expense. And the fall sports season starts Monday, August 11th. You must have your physical paperwork turned into the athletic director's office before Monday, August 11th. And attention, members of the girls' track team. Today is the last day to get your tickets to the championship banquet. If you forgot your money today, stop by the athletic office to let them know the number of tickets you want and so they can hold them and have a correct count. And congratulations to the following lacrosse players. Ashley Von Minden, All-Pac-10 first team defense. Shannon Shivek, All-Pac-10 second team attack. Renee Maniscalco, All-Pac-10 second team attack. Devin Miller, All-Pac-10 second team attack, and Jackie Donovan, All-Pac-10 honorable mention. Any girls interested in playing field hockey in the fall that did not attend the meeting last week, please see Ms. Judge in room 126 sometime before the end of the day. That's it in sports. Now let's take it back to Kelly.
Thank you, Rachel. And now here's a word from the office. On the lunch menu for today, it's your choice of pizza or tuna hoagie. A happy 18th birthday goes out to Glenn Love Mel.
Oh, that's nice. All right, this is Spring for the Morning for Monday, June 2nd, the 171st day of school, a C day. It's the last Monday for seniors. With Kelly Early, Rachel Harsh, I'm Shane Eisenhower. Have a most pleasant Monday. And stay tuned for another heartwarming Springford music video.
Now I have the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
Cause I had the time of my life, and I owe it all to you.
I've been waiting for so long, now I finally found someone to stand by me.
Oh,
Good morning, Springfield. I'm Pierre Salomon here with Kelly Early. The final issue of The Rampage will go on sale tomorrow. If you would like a copy, please see any member of the Rampage staff or see Mr. Rutter in room 157. Look out for the front cover for the senior collage. Seniors, if you're going to apply to Montgomery County Community College, you can save the $20 application fee by applying online. Please don't forget to notify guidance so your transcripts will be sent. Juniors in the National Honor Society who wish to help out at graduation or baccalaureate should sign up in the Media Center.
To complete library inventory, the Media Center will now be closed to classes and study halls. Library aides must still report. Students may return books before school or after school each day. All books must be returned and all fines must be paid to receive a diploma and or a report card. There will be yet another brief mandatory meeting for the newly elected junior class officers today, immediately after school in room 151.
There will be a very important art enrichment meeting on Thursday, June 5th in room 164. Every member should attend. The meeting will run until 3:30 only. Anchor Club will have its final meeting of the year Thursday after school in room 122. If you are interested in running for office, you must attend. Please bring in a stamp and a snack item. Again, we will be holding elections for next year's officers.
Summer school registration will begin on Monday, June 9th, and run until Wednesday, June 18th. Please see Mrs. Ryan in the main office from 8:30 until 2:30 p.m. to obtain a registration form. No registrations will be accepted after June 18th. To be eligible to attend summer school, every student must have earned at least a 60% in a course and could not have been absent for more than 24 days.
Attention Science Club members, the final Science Club meeting and pizza party will be on Tuesday, June 10th after school. You must see Ms. Lannis in room 103 by Monday, June 9th in order to attend. And now here's Rachel Harsh with the sports.
All right, members of the girls track team, you must stop by the athletic office starting today for your sizing of the championship jacket. And all senior athletes who have tickets to the senior athletic banquet at Lakeside this evening, we will start promptly at 6:30. The doors will open at 6, and please be on time. This is a very special event, so please dress appropriately. The fall sports season starts Monday, August 11th. You must have your physical paperwork turned into the athletic director's office before Monday, August 11th. That's it in sports, and let's take it back to Kelly.
Thanks, Rachel, and now here's a word from the office. Thank you, Mrs. Savage. And now here's Justin Blustery Digby with the finger on the weather pulse.
Thank you, Kelly. As you can see, there is still rain around, but I'm expecting it to be moving off soon, hopefully by the end of the week. It's supposed to be nice. So let's go to the 4-day. It's supposed to be partly cloudy the next couple days with highs getting up near 80, but again, the rain comes back for Saturday, and what a big surprise, it's going to be another bad weekend. Now back to the desk.
Well, thanks, Digby. On the lunch menu for today, it's your choice of chicken fries or hamburger barbecue.
This is Springford in the Morning for Wednesday, June 4th, the 173rd day of school in E-Day. With Kelly Early, Rachel Harsh, and Justin Blustery Digby, I am Pierre Salomon. Have a fantastic day.
Oh, Mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting end to my running and I'm so far from my home. Oh, Mama, I can hear you a-crying, you're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows and I don't have very long.
Good morning, Springford. I'm Shane Eisenhower, here with Kelly Early. Well, following students, please report to the cafeteria lobby. Megan Reese, Hillary Tutrani, Kelly Early, Josh Ziegler, Chris Brower, Dave Black, Nicole Hanby, Kendra James, Kelly O'Neill, Ryan Kraft, Tom Murphy, Drew Kurtz, Sue Lebo, Sarah Gaiman, Jim Nusky, Wayne Shope, Dustin McDaniel, and Craig Clark. And here are the winners of the student council election: President Carly Snyder, Vice President Kat Ancharsky, Treasurer Kristen Welch, and Secretary Leanne Boyle. Congratulations from the Blewett and Garrett administration. And the final issue of the Rampage will go on sale today. If you would like a copy, please see any member of the Rampage staff or see Mr. Rudder in room 157. Look out for the front cover for the senior collage.
Juniors in National Honor Society who wish to help at graduation or baccalaureate should sign up in the Media Center. All students are reminded that they are to pick up any medications they have in the nurse's office prior to taking finals. Seniors may pick up their medications today. Any medications that are not picked up prior to the end of school on June 13th will be thrown away.
There will be a very important art enrichment meeting today, June 5th, in room 164. Every member should attend. The meeting will run until 3:30 only. And the Anchor Club will have its final meeting of the year today after school in room 122. If you are interested in running for office, you must attend. Please bring a stamp and a snack item. Again, we'll be holding elections for next year's officers.
From the freshman English teachers,
the American Film Institute has announced its list of 100 greatest villains and heroes of film history. The number one greatest character is Atticus Finch, To Kill a Mockingbird, beating out Superman and Indiana Jones. But then, we here at Springford always knew that.
Summer school registration will begin on Monday, June 9th, and run until Wednesday, June 18th. Please see Mrs. Ryan in the main office from 8:30 until 2:30 to obtain a registration form. No registrations will be accepted after June 18th. To be eligible to attend summer school, every student must have earned at least a 60% in a course and could not have been absent for more than 24 days.
Attention Science Club members, the final Science Club meeting and pizza party will be Tuesday, June 10th after school. You must see Ms. Landis in room 103 by Monday, June 9th in order to attend. Attention students and staff, yearbooks will be distributed to seniors only at lunchtime today. Only seniors who order one and have a yearbook ticket will be able to pick up their book today. Yearbook will be distributed at lunchtime in the cafeteria lobby. Any senior who did not order a yearbook ahead of time may purchase one after school today in room 109. Do not come to room 109 for any questions today until after school. Staff, be sure you have distributed the yearbook tickets to your homeroom and return the undistributed to Mrs. Force today. And underclassmen will receive the yearbooks at lunch tomorrow in the cafeteria lobby. You must have your ticket to get your yearbook. No extra yearbooks will be sold until after school for you underclassmen, if there are any. Remember, you must have the ticket, and no yearbooks will be distributed until lunch or after school. And now here's Rachel Harsh with the sports for the last time.
All right. Okay, that's kind of sad. any 9th, 10th, or 11th grade girl interested in trying out for the Keystone State field hockey team this Sunday at Plymouth White Marsh High School, please see Miss Judge in room 126 either today or tomorrow. Members of the girls' track team, you may stop by the athletic office starting today for sizing of your championship jacket. The fall sports season starts Monday, August 11th. You must have your physical paperwork turned into the athletic director's office before Monday, August 11th. The 9th grade spring sports pizza and wings party for the 9th grade baseball and 9th grade lacrosse team will be held today after school in the high school faculty dining room. You will need to provide your own transportation home. And any 9th, 10th, or 11th grade girl interested in attending lacrosse camp this summer, please see Ms. Judge in room 126 sometime today. That's it in sports for the last time. Let's take it back to Kelly.
Thanks, Rachel. I'm so sad. But now here's a word from Ms. Savage in the office.
on the weather pulse. And be sure to check out Blustery's patented 4-day.
Up there so that she could help me out to do my weather report. Anyway, as you can see, the weather map is full of H's and L's, which is, you know, typical of this past week. The low that Dara's pointing at right now brought us the rain the past 2 days, and it's going to move off. But the next two lows up and down, that's going to bring us more rain next week. Let's go to the 4-day. As you can see, it's going to be a pretty decently good day the next 2 days, but it's going to be another rain out this weekend. And I looked forward, and I looked ahead at the report for graduation, and unfortunately, they're saying a few showers, but I don't think it will. So now back to the desk.
Okay. Yeah. So on the lunch menu for today, it's your choice of hoagies and roast beef. Happy 18th birthday goes out to Andy Love Deirdre.
Aww.
The happiest of birthdays goes out to Debbie Hall from her friends at the high school and Mrs. Mancini.
Mm. All right, well, this is Spring Forward in the Morning for Wednesday, June 5th, the 174th day of school, and F Day, the last day of school for seniors. With Kelly Early, Rachel Harsh, and Justin Bluster Digby, and everybody else here, I'm Shane Eisenhower. And to the graduating class of 2003, your mission is to seek out new life and new civilizations. To boldly go where no man has gone before.
Bye.
Have a good one. We'll
Bye.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
This is how it feels. As we go on,
tomorrow like we think about now? Can we survive it out there? Can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end, and suddenly it's like the women and men.